Hello all, we are having here the next topic of design and analysis of algorithm, that is sorting network. So as the name suggests, it is nothing but the sorting of an element. It is nothing but the networks for used for sorting of an element. So elements can be n number of the elements, right? So this is the use of sorting network, right? So why there is the why we are using here the sorting network, right? So and what do we mean by sorting network? How we can implement that sorting network? Then what are the contents of the sorting network? That means what are the components of the sorting network? How many types of sorting networks are there? So this n number of the questions that we can this n number of the questions that I am giving you the answer for this, right? So what do I mean by first of all comparison network? First of all, we are implementing or we are comparing the elements. We can compare the elements, that is already we are having the algorithms or the software techniques, software implementation like bubble sort, insertion sort, selection sort, merge sort, heap sort, then again n number of quick sort. So these are n number of the algorithms that they are available to done the comparison, but they are already available there in the software. That means they are implemented, we can use that techniques using the software. Then we have to write the program to implement all of these techniques. So the next type of the technique that is available, that is we can implement the comparison using the hardware also. That means comparison networks, we can implement that comparison network using the hardware, right? So why we are using that, why there is a need of implementation of the comparison network using the hardware? Because they are already available, that is software techniques are already available. So if we compare the comparison network and our software available techniques, the complexity is again reduced in the comparison network, because we are here doing the connection of n number of the comparisons and they are connected parallel. They are connected parallelly, that's why they are speeding up the comparison. And again the complexity is reduced in the comparison network. So these are the two advantages of using the comparison network. Fine. So keep it in mind, always comparison networks are implemented in hardware. So for the hardware, there are the basic components requirement, that is first is the wire and second is the doing of the comparison. That means we require the comparator, one box to do the comparison. That box is called as the comparator, right? So first of all we will discuss the comparison network is implemented in hardware. Next is using the software and number of the algorithms that they are available. So n number of the algorithms, among that best case complexity algorithms we generally know, that is heap sort and the merge sort, and they provide the best case complexity, that is n log n. But in the comparison network we are getting the complexity as log square n, and it is much more reduced as compared to the n log n. Fine. So that's why there is the need of using the comparator networks. If we implement using the hardware, again the complexity is improved. That means it is again giving the best complexity as compared to the software. So what is the advantage of using it? It is, first is we are getting the reduced complexity, that is log square n, and second it is speeding up because we are doing the connection in parallel. Fine. So first of all we will see the comparison network, what are the components required to it. The components required are the, already I told you, that is wires and comparator, because they are implemented in hardware. Fine. So n number of the wires we require and n number of the comparators that we require. So sorting networks are comparison networks. Sorting network, comparison network again called as the, another name is a sorting network, that always sort their input. So whatsoever input we are having, they are unsorted, and we have to sort that input using the comparator, and we will get the sorted output. Fine. So this is the working of comparison or the sorting network. What is the working? First, we are having the unsorted input. We have to apply that input to the comparator and we will get the sorted output. Fine. So what are the components of the sorting network or the comparison network? First component is the wire. So it will transmit the value from one place to another place, and next is the comparator to compare the in between element. That is, if we are having the two input, we will get the sorted two output. Fine. So here, how to implement it? So this is the pictorial representation of the comparison network or the sorting network. First, we are having the if. For example, we are having the x and y as input. We will get the output, that is the sorted one, x dash and y dash. So what do I mean by x dash? X dash is minimum of x and y. So whatever minimum value in between x and y, we will get it. And y dash is maximum value of x and y. So whatever maximum value we will get, we have to put that value in the y dash. So here, pictorial representation of the comparison network. We are having here x and y unsorted output, and output we are getting after comparison. There is a comparator that we placed here, and in the comparator we will get x dash and y dash. So what comparator is doing? It is calculating mean of x and y and putting that minimum value to the x dash, and it is y dash is and we are getting second value as a y dash. So here we are getting the comparator, using comparator we are getting maximum of x and y, and maximum value will be put in the y dash. Fine. So please note it down, draw the diagram for it, because we are solving the algorithm based on it, and there are n number of the input, not only two input. So we have to note it down. Fine. So next, if I want to implement, this is the pictorial representation, or the we can say it as a theoretical representation of the comparison network. If I want to implement it practically, so what I will do, I am having the x and y, fine, and we are providing here the wire. So this horizontal line is called as wire, and this vertical line is called as a comparator. So in between this, I am again connecting the comparator and doing the comparison in between x and y, and I am getting the minimum and maximum value. So while solving the numerical, you have to use this representation, not this pictorial representation. Fine. So always keep it in mind that x and y, these are the input which are unsorted, and this horizontal line is called as the wires and vertical line is called as the comparator. Fine. So comparators, if we are having the n input wires, and the sequence of n input wire, that is unsorted sequence, fine. So a1, a2, a3, an n number of the input sequence are there, then it is always generating the n number of the output. That means how many equivalent inputs that I am having. If I am having the 7 input, is it always generating the 7 output. If I am having the 8 input, it is always generating the 8 output. But 8 inputs are unsorted and 8 outputs are sorted. Sorted in the ascending order. Sorted in the ascending order, or according to our natural number system. Fine. So if we are having the n input, it is always generating the n outputs. So this is the pictorial representation of the sorting network. I already told you that sorting networks are nothing but the network that is used for sorting of the numbers, and they are connected parallelly. So what do you mean by they are connected parallelly? See here, n number of the comparator columns are given here, 1, 2, 3, and n number of the comparator columns are given here, fine. So we are having connection of this n number of the comparators parallel. We are having the n number of comparators connection as parallel. They are performing the comparison parallelly, and they are speeding up the computation. They are speeding up the input wires are there, n number of the comparators that they are connected here parallelly, and they are performing the computation parallelly, and it is giving us the output as compared, it is giving us the output very frequent as compared to the our traditional technique, fine. So here it is the representation of the typical sorting network, and every sorting network is made up of a series of columns. Series of columns means it is connected parallelly. It is connected parallelly and doing comparison parallelly and giving us the speed up output. Giving us the speed up output, and output is sorted. Fine. So next concept is how to perform the comparison. How to perform the comparison. N number of the comparator networks are here, A1, A2, A3, A4. Consider if this A1, A2, A3, A4 are the input wire, and the values in the input wire are 9, 5, 2, 6. So see, these values are unsorted. So we will get the sorted output on B1, B2, B3, B4. There are F4 input, so we will get here 4 output. Fine. So if I am doing the comparison in between A1 and A2, so I will perform here the connection, that is connect representation of the comparator. Comparator name is A. Here again A3 and A4 I am doing comparison, so comparator connection is there, that is vertical line is there, and name it is a B. Similarly, if I want to perform the comparison in between A1 and A3, so here vertical line is there and name of the comparator is C. Again I am comparing in between A2 and A4, again the comparison connection is there, comparator vertical line is there, and name of the comparator is D. Again I am doing comparison between A2 and A3, again vertical line is there, and naming of this one is the E. Fine. So if I am doing the initial step, that is A, B, C, D and E are the comparator, fine. So if I want to do the comparison in between A1 and A2, fine. So again I already told you that note down X and Y, it is giving us X dash and Y dash. Whatever the minimum value in between X and Y, it is on the first line, that is X dash, and whatever maximum value of X and Y, it is giving on the below line, that is Y dash, fine. So here in this 9 and 5, if I will do here comparison, so it is A1 and A2. So minimum of A1 and A2, that is 9 and 5, it comes on the first line, that is 5. And maximum of 9 and 5, that is the maximum value, that is comes on the second line, that is 9. Fine. So here again similarly I am performing the comparison 2 and 6. So minimum is 2, that is remain as it is here, and maximum is 6, that remains here. Fine. So for the second comparator, that is C and D, we are performing here the recent output. So for C and D, we are having again comparison in between A1 and A3. So in between A1 and A3, that is recent output is 5 and 2. Remember always in this numerical, whatsoever the processing required, we have to perform the processing on the recent output, that is 5926, not the old output 9526. Fine. So in between A1 recent value is 5 and A3 recent value is 2. So in between 5 and 2, are they sorted? No. So minimum value of this is 2 is on the A1, and maximum value of 2 and 5, that is 5, it is on the A3. Fine. So next we have to perform the computation or the comparison between the A2 and A3, that is connector D. Fine. So what is the recent output for it is? It is 9 and 6. So in between the 9 and 6, what is the minimum value? Minimum value is the 6 and maximum value is 9. So a minimum value becomes on the A2, that is 6, and maximum value, that is 9, on the A4, that is 9, that is on the A4. Fine. So again in between the third level comparator, that this is called as a second level, this is called as a first level, that is doing comparison in parallelly and giving output 5 9 2 and 6, again doing comparison parallelly giving output 2 6
5 and 9. Again, the third level comparator that required, that is called as E. So it is in between A2 and A3. So in between A2 and A3, what is the recent output? 6 and 5. So it will do the comparison giving minimum value out of 6 and 5, that is 5 on the A2 and 6 on the A3. Fine. So we will get the output, that is 2, 5, 6 and 9. Fine. So remember, the last comparator is only in between A2 and A3, not in between A1 and A4. Fine. That's why there is only the copying of value of the recent level 2 comparator, that is 2 and 9. Fine. So we were getting 2, 5, 6 and 9 here values. So what is the depth to calculate the n number of the maximum comparator? Fine. So what is the definition of depth? We will see first. So depth is nothing but called as the maximum number of comparators on a path from input wire to the output wire. Fine. So from the input wire to the output wire, maximum number of comparator is first comparator, second comparator and third. So first level, second level and third level. Fine. So the depth for this comparator is 3. Fine. So next is. So for input wire depth, dx and dy is the depth for the input. So output wire depth is maximum of dx comma dy plus 1. So here maximum depth start with 0. So it is nothing but depth. It is first it is 1 1, second it is 2 and 2, so it is 1 and 1, so it is 2 and 2, and third it is 3. Fine. So to calculate depth, you understand the formula, that is output wire depth, it is maximum of dx comma dy plus 1. So what is the value of dx? Dx it is 1 and dy it is 1. So depth is 1 and 1, then second level depth is 2 and 2, and third level depth is 3. Fine. So next it is definition. Sorting network is again the comparison network where output is sorted. So comparison network, another name is the sorting network. So output sequence is always monotonically increasing. That is, B1 value is always less than or equal to B2, B2 is always less than or equal to B3 till B of n. So n number of the value always less than or equal to the previous value. Fine. So how it is? Because it is monotonically increasing. What do you mean by monotonically increasing? Means it is arranged in the ascending order. Fine. So monotonically increasing means it is arranged in the ascending order, and monotonically decreasing means it is arranged in the descending order. Fine. So comparison network is a procedure in that it specifies how comparisons are to occur. Fine. So next topic is bitonic sorting network. It is the second type of the sorting network. For that we have to understand what is bitonic sequence. Next is how to implement the bitonic sorter and how to solve the numericals based on that bitonic sorter. We'll see that topic in the next video lecture. Thank you.